And this hand, while not great, I am going to keep. We have turn two, scrying for another piece, or potentially just stirrings, depending on what we draw. It's possible we actually are just scrying up a... well, if we draw a Tron piece, then this hand's amazing. Right here, if we draw one we don't have, either of those eight lands. And we did. So we're just going to go ahead and scrying for the last one. This was pretty absurd. Spells there, jeez. That card's so bad against me. If he plays untapped, he's just going to lightning bolt me, because Spellsnare is just like really bad in this matchup, I think. Isn't it? Am I wrong? Yeah, it seems really terrible. I can't imagine the card's supposed to be an after board. But it did some damage right there. And now he can potentially just leak my stirrings, which is kind of frustrating. I think I'm okay with it. I'm going to play the sphere. Maybe he'll leak this. Ooh, there's the last piece we need. I don't really care if he leaks this. We're going to get a piece of stone rain is the problem now on the next turn. I think I still stirrings. It's possible stirrings in here is actually wrong. And I need to save it so I know what to replace after he stone rains. I'm not sure. Well, I like baiting a leak here. Alright, so I think I'm actually going to take a map instead of Wormcoil. Under the theory that these Karns will be enough. Hope it doesn't go leak stone rain, which is, yeah. If he's leaking, he has stone rain 100%, which is unfortunate. So now we're going to get lucky and draw out of this. Can't believe we got spell snared. It's so gross. Maybe, like... stopping Power Glass is so important that it's worth it. Ooh, he didn't have the Stun Rain there. Okay. Oh, he has Click. Haha, Karn coming in. So we're going to go ahead and just plus Karn here for sure. He has to take it. He can't leave it with a backup card. Then I can like minus really aggressively and stick a second one. That seems crazy. Oh, he left me with both. Okay, so does that change anything? Do I want to minus the card now? I kind of do. I think now I can just minus the card on the click. He's not playing like O-ring or anything, is he? No. He could be playing, geez, what if he's playing Pithing Needle? That'd be really gross. I sort of like Karn minus Karn, because if he bolts it, I can play another Karn next turn and pay for leak. So that's only bad if he has Remand specifically. Or I guess if he has Bolt and Stone Rain, or Bolt and Tech Edge, it's bad. Yeah, I'm just going to plus the card and play the quarter. And this, I think, it plays around him just like bolting and then Stone Raining me, or bolting and Tech Edging me, and keeping me off of the second... the second card. Like, he didn't seem concerned to me about having two of them. So that bothers me a little bit. Yeah, he's gonna try to race me now, I guess. Interesting. Okay, so he's letting the card just sit there. So I can, like, double card this turn if I want to. I kind of like just plussing card, playing card, plussing card. Got an island out of him here. Okay, so let's... I guess there's no real reason to... play the second card. Like, if he has Cryptic, he gets a counterbounce. Just gonna Sphere here for red. And there was good to use card first in case he wants a Cryptic this. I've already got the usage out of it. Oh, I did bring a claim in. Okay, I didn't even realize that. Well, that means I can stop piling needle pretty effectively. I'm gonna play the mine here. Am I? No, I'm actually gonna play the forest here. There's two cards in hand, so he can't have like that much burn. Yeah, okay, so you're just playing Snapcaster. And it's gonna hit me. Okay. So if at any point we find a Pyroclasm, the game just ends. I can also try just minusing this card now and just take out his creatures. Or I guess take out the Colonnade Brain, maybe. Oh no, I need to take out Colonnade, I have Ghost Quarter. Okay, so. I guess we don't actually have red mana here. Oh, well, now we do. Duff is going to minus this. There's no reason to restart the game here. Is there? I guess I can minus card and play the second card. Minus that card, take them both out. No, I can't minus the second card. So if I do that, the plus the second card, get his last card. Which I don't mind doing. Take out the click. Play the mine, play the Karn. I mean, I'm worried I'm getting too cute here. Like, but the only way I really lose this game is if I get burnt out somehow. Although realistically, I guess the way I lose is if he has like Thunderbolt Hellkite. Yeah, I like plussing this other card here. If it's Cryptic, it's not like a disaster for me, I think. This way I get to like, play around Thundermaw. Alright, it's still land. But this is a much safer line, I think. I'll just quarter the colonnade if it attacks me. Yeah, so Snapcaster pushes me to 10. Alright. And now we just draw. Ooh, okay, I drew an O-Stone. Yeah, I can safely go to 7. Yeah, and this one should be wrapped up now. Now we'll just start plussing our card. Put the counter on it. And there we go. Sweet. All right. Yeah, so that was Red Green Tron. The deck performed very well. I mean, the deck certainly has a decent amount of variance in it because you're just kind of pushing this very linear plan. And we drew double Tron piece in a lot of our openings. We had relatively few problems getting Tron in play. And I think that doesn't happen quite as easily as we saw it here. At least in my experience playing the deck. And I think historically I've actually been on the other side of the variance where I've just consistently failed to ever assemble Tron and got really frustrated from playing it. And here he's on the other side. I don't really like this All Is Dust in the deck. I don't think this is what you want in your main deck. Another expensive spell. You have to have Tron to for it to do anything. Maybe it is good as a one of, but I feel like this is not a great card in the deck. I think I wouldn't be playing it. I probably want a fourth Relic. I think the matchup where it's good, it's just so good. And it's never bad, it always just cycles. We also got pretty lucky. We avoided much sideboard hate. We didn't see any Sowing Salts or any of the Stony Silences, which are both really good against the deck. So we were very fortunate there. But yeah, the deck definitely performed. And I think it's certainly a good contender in the format. I think it's also kind of a fun deck to play giant stuff. And it does have some play to it. I mean, we certainly had spots where we got to play around things and had to think through some lines. And I think that is, you know, about what you're looking for in a modern deck. So I think this deck is certainly sweet. But yeah, so thanks for watching. Be back again with some more of the kind of B-tier modern decks in the coming days. Thanks.